Hey guys, it's Justin. Got a boatload of stuff to share with you. Got some stuff from my friend Dave. Thank you. Good to meet you. And I'm really glad we could have met up the other day. He had some goodies for me. And let's go through some of them. So let's start out. We have record-wise, I had let him know some stuff I don't have. So I didn't have Made in the USA yet. So I'd like to formally review each of these albums at some point. Not right now, but this is just a brief look at what's on the inside. I never owned this on CD or tape or anything, so I just thought it would be great to have an album that has California Dreamin' and Rock and Roll to the Rescue. And it's just a really cool collection of pictures and whatnot, so there's that. You're listening to Girl on the Beach by Rick Hinn of the Sunrays. This is all actually California Music Volume 1. Nice picture of Brian and Marilyn there. And there's some different... This is California Music. This is stuff influenced by the Beach Boys and stuff that influenced them. So this is like... This was made years ago. And this is a really good collection. I haven't even touched the surface of how many volumes he has, so can't wait to get to Eric Carmen's She Did It. Here we have Leif Garrett, and you're probably sighing like, why is this in here? But we have some related stuff. California Girls and Surfing USA. So that's cool. And also... Just The Wanderer and Johnny B. Goode were also on the guys' concert album. Not that they wrote them or anything, but... And Runaround Sue was definitely influenced. Obviously, Dion influenced... obviously influenced Brian Wilson, so... and I don't think there was anybody involved with this as far as Beach Boys... just a brief look through here. So, we also have the High Lows, which I don't know as well, but I know they, definitely influenced Brian, vocally. Here we have BJ Thomas, my friend, again, Dave, told me about this song. I want to say it's Rock and Roll Lullaby. Yeah. And he said that it is very Beach Boy-esque, so I gotta take a listen to this. It's gonna be a good one. And I finally got my hands on Carl Wilson, the self-titled LP. So I can't wait to listen to this. I've heard most of the music on here, but not lately. So looks very similar to something that... Or looks similar to Youngblood as far as font and all that. Oh, and finally I have my hands... on a copy of Surfin' Safari, a original reissue. So, a little taped up, but you know what? That's alright. When you get these things non-charged, you don't really care what kind of... when you get how much they are, so... I don't really care what condition they are in, folks. I'll take what I can get. So, it was really great to... meet him, and because he's never met, you know, been with people who actually, you know, enjoy the Beach Boys. He just, you know, knows people online. So, and I believe this is the last album, Boats Against the Current. And I had always heard that Brian Wilson did backing vocals to that song itself, but I'm not seeing anything in here to indicate that. And let alone I thought maybe if it was Bruce, but that's not even on here. And then I've also heard that some people say that She Did It has Brian Wilson on it, but it doesn't. It's very influenced by the Beach Boys. And we'll see here, we have Bruce Johnston. He's definitely credited all over the place here for backing vocals and organizing vocals, so that's cool. And Kurt Becker, which is another good one from that time. So there's that. Well, Eric Carmen action. I really suggest listening to She Did It. It's great. So it's Boats Against Current. We got a picture sleeve of Please Let Me Wonder and Do You Want to Dance? Pretty awesome. And the single of Rock and Roll Music and Found It In, It Snows In, It's That Time Again. Share the Road. Share the Load, Hit the Road. That's it, moron. Finally, I never did have this on, never did have this single. We're really happy to have it, so, oops. Great to see this on 45. I love the instrumental cut of this. It reminds me of Why, actually, the unreleased song that's on Made in California, which really sounds new and really doesn't sound like it's from MIU, but supposedly that's where it dates from, so those guys gotta be right. So there's that. Glad to add these to my 45s. So here we have, and I've not really done any book reviews in a while. I already had this, I had bought off Amazon used Steve Gaines, but this is the original paperback, I believe, so it's great to have this. Obviously worn, but that's all right. I love having this stuff. So I wonder if it's the same quotes and stuff on the back. Let's see. It looks different. Yeah. So obviously this one was a later release, obviously, since it's bigger. So interesting they chose a different picture. And then I didn't realize when he had handed it to me, this is actually the same book. I have the Dominic Priori Smile book, which is kind of controversial in its own right, as a lot of people have said before. But it's got the same pictures in it that are in this one. Obviously, it's the same book, which I thought was a really interesting read. But I thought when they changed up the core, I just wasn't sure if it was the same thing. So there we go. Now I've got two copies, which is awesome. Love having that. So, and then this is very interesting. I had already had Keith Badman's version of this, and we all know that he did a no-no and put all the Wrecking Crew's Social Security numbers in their rut-row. So obviously there was going to be a release of this book without the Social Security numbers. And so when I opened up this, when I had this lovely box, noticed that this is the version that has the SSN numbers, Social Security numbers blocked out. So fortunately it looks kind of subtle that way. So there we go. It's all blocked off. Very interesting. There was that page I just was on for Wouldn't It Be Nice. And then the other doubles I've got, I'd already had this by Andrew G. Doe and John Tobler, which is a great read. I highly suggest it. And I didn't realize, I kind of forgot that this was also released, but this actually has different pictures, and this is an earlier edition, so I would assume that it's the same stuff.